In the months that followed that magical night, the story of how the drummer boy regained his speech became legend. People spoke of it as a miracle, and it was known not only to the people of his own village, but throughout the land. People came from miles around just to see him and hear his story in his own words, and naturally to hear him play his drum, which he still cherished as much as ever. One evening, just before sunset, as the family was completing their evening meal, there came a knock upon their door. "Who would call at this hour?" wondered the drummer boy's mother out loud, as she rose from her position near the fire to see who was knocking. "Probably someone wanting to hear about the miracle of the drummer boy," agreed his siblings with hints of envy in their voices. As the widow swung the door open, she was startled. A massive and powerful figure stood before her. Silhouetted against the bright light of the sun, which was setting behind him, the sharp contrast made it impossible to recognize who he might be. "Who are you, kind sir? And what interests bring you to our humble home?" she asked in a slightly frightened voice, as her eyes darted quickly about the image before her, searching for any recognizable clues. Just as the visitor opened his mouth to respond, she saw the huge bag by his side. "The Toymaker!" she exclaimed. "Please forgive me for not recognizing you immediately. Do come in." The old man ducked slightly to pass through the small portal into the widow's humble home. As he did, his face was bathed in the soft flickering light of the fire, eliminating her last lingering doubt of his identity. "You honor our home," said the widow. "To what do we owe such unexpected privilege?"
"Three purposes bring me here, kind lady. First, I am to admonish you. During my last visit to your village, you brought only one child to see me, yet you have others. I have come to share with your other children what small happiness I may offer from my bag of humble toys. Will you permit me that pleasure?"
"Of course you may, sir. And again, you will leave me in your debt. May I at least impose upon you to share supper with us?" offered the widow.
"Your offer is very kind, dear lady, but I have only recently eaten," answered the toy maker, mindful not to impose upon the widow's generous hospitality, but most meager means. "Shamefully," the old man admitted, "the second reason for my visit is like that of so many others. I wish to hear the miracle of the drummer boy, firsthand. Will you allow your son to share his story with me?"
"I am sure he would be happy to tell you his story," smiled the drummer boy's mother. "He shares it eagerly with anyone who asks." Upon reaching these agreements, the old man positioned himself near the fire. One by one, he listened to the wishes of each of the drummer boy's sisters and brothers, each time finding a toy in his bag that caused them to beam. This was a magical night they would never forget.